Yes, what does Sam Vance say? He always says, if you're not nervous, you don't care enough.
My name is Mara Siets. I've been licensed for 8 years, and I've been working with Redken products for about 6 years. I work at Fuel Salon and Store in Tallahassee, Florida. When I started cosmetology school, I learned that I was a very science-minded cosmetologist, and that's a lot of what got me through school was the passion to learn about the science of this industry. And when I found Redken products, I found that they were so science-based and principle-based that I always had an answer for all of my questions. I recently became a level 4A stylist at my salon, and now I train associates to get on our floor. Since I started doing that, I learned that I love teaching and I love giving my associates their aha moments that I get when I go to a Redken class. And that's why I want to be part of this Redken tribe, to help teach others and to give them the confidence to be a great cosmetologist behind the chair. Today I'm going to be demonstrating a touch-up on a balayage that I did 2 years ago on my model Alice. Since it's grown out, now she wants to get a little bit more brightness but still keep some depth, and I find that a lot of people get a little confused when touching up a balayage as opposed to being really confident applying a virgin application of a balayage. I'm going to start Alice's hair with a pre-shampoo using Redken's hair cleansing cream to get a really nice clean canvas, and then I'll be blow drying her 100% dry before I start the application. This is my mom Alice, and this is our canvas. As you can see, her balayage has grown out. She wants to add some brightness towards zone 1 and keep some depth in zone 2 and have her bright ends at the bottom, and she wants a low maintenance grow out, so that's what we're going to do for her today.
Doing a light shampoo before a service allows you to do several things. It gives you the opportunity to do any pre-treatments if you'd like or if you need to, and it also gives you a chance to really clean the canvas and not have anything impeding the potency of the product that you're applying. I'm choosing Redken Hair Cleansing Cream to do this today because it's a really mild chelating shampoo and gets the canvas really nice and clean for me. Now I'm going to be using Redken High Rise Conditioner just for a really light detangling conditioner for the ends so that I don't really hurt my client as I'm combing through her hair and sectioning her for this balayage.
I'm going to be using one of my favorite products, Redken Flash Lift with Blonder Inside. I love the consistency of this, and I love that it takes a couple of steps out of my day, which helps me really be time efficient. So I'm using this in a 1:1.5 ratio. I love the consistency of that for painting because it gives me a kind of a cupcake frosting consistency, so it's not too runny and it's not too thick. And while Flash Lift Blonder Inside was not originally made for balayage, it works really, really well because of the consistency and the freedom I have to mix it how I want. So to start out, I'm using 15 volume with my Flash Lift Blonder Inside. Alice's hair is only around a level 8, so I know I don't have to lift very high very fast, so that's why I'm starting with such a low level. I'm going to be insulating each section with some balayage film, because I don't want each section to touch another section while I'm still working in it, so I can keep it really isolated.
A really nice way to get the perfect size bead of lighter on your brush is to scrape your brush on the side of the bowl and then cut the amount of product that you want to the perfect size bead for your lightener application. Probably my favorite area to paint, and I think one of the most overlooked areas to paint on the hair during a balayage, is the bottom hairline. I like to paint both sides so that there's points of light when they put their hair up in a ponytail, but also light in the interior of the hair. And then I grab more product from my color bowl to connect my points of light. And then to saturate, I like to fill my hand with some product and then saturate from the bottom and the top. Another important area is the hairline right behind the ear. The reason this area is important is because it's very visible when your hair is put up in a ponytail, and it's always very visible when the hair is pushed forward to the front when their hair is down. To achieve this, I'll paint both the side of my balayage section and also the top. Then I'll load my brush again and connect my points together. After that, I'll load my brush once again and apply it into the palm of my hand, and then I'll saturate from the bottom and the top, pushing through the section and opening it with my brush to get the product all the way through. At this point, it's time to remix my lightener. I mix my lightener in small batches that I can get through in about 15 to 20 minutes. If I mix a really big batch, it could lose its potency by the time I get to the end of the bowl, and then I won't have the lift that I desire. This also gives me the opportunity to increase my developer strength as I go. Balayage is an extremely custom application. It's important to assess your previous section before applying your points of light on the section you're currently in. This is another reason I like to use clear balayage film, so I can see my previous section and where I applied my points last. For this sectioning pattern, I'm utilizing large triangle sections. And as I move up the head, I'm bricklaying these sections. This also helps me to bricklay my points of light, which ensures that I get even distribution of light and depth. It's important during a balayage touch-up that you don't overlap the client's previous color to cause extra damage. When using lightener, bonds are broken 15 to 20% every single time you lighten, so we have to take the utmost care to not continue to break bonds. As we move to the last section in the back of the head, I assess the last points of light that I placed in the last section and decide how many points of light and where I want them on the very last section on the top. Since I know Alice wanted to see more brightness on the surface of her hair, I decided to place 5 points of light. This also achieves a really sun-kissed look, like Alice has been sitting at the beach for like 3 weeks. And mimicking Mother Nature is a challenge I accept every day behind the chair. As we move to the side of the head, I start with another large triangle going diagonally backwards, meeting the front hairline with the top of the ear. This makes it easy for me to address the front hairline to give points of light for a beautiful ponytail. And just like in the back hairline, I'll be painting the underneath side of my section and the top side of my section. As I move up the side of the head, my next triangle section will be placed horizontally, and I'll place a diagonally forward going point of light so that I have depth over my last point of light from my previous section and light over my last point of depth in my previous section. So, to recap what we did on a head form, I started by separating the crown, the back, and the nape sections down the middle of the head. From there, I took 2 triangular sections on either side at the back of the hairline, one going diagonally back on the left side and one going diagonally back on the right side. Then, after I complete those two sections, I connect them with a horizontally placed triangle and repeat that pattern all the way up the top of the head to the crown. On the sides, I alternate diagonally back and horizontally placed triangles, leaving out the apex forward. After Alice processed for 40 minutes, it was time to remove the balayage film. I chose to shampoo Alice with Redken Nature & Science Extreme Shampoo. I love to shampoo after a lightning service with a protein-forward shampoo. After a lightning service, we've effectively made potholes in the integrity of the hair. And protein is effectively like concrete, filling in those potholes and giving us a smooth, evened out surface again. After I rinse the shampoo out, I'm going to squeeze excess moisture out of the hair and apply my favorite treatment Redken offers, CAT treatment. CAT treatment stands for Cysteic Acid Treatment. When disulfide bonds are broken during a color service, they release cysteic acid. And cysteic acid loves to eat more bonds. And as it eats those bonds, it travels up the hair shaft, eventually making the hair break because it's too weak. CAT treatment is like applying a fortified band-aid, keeping cysteic acid from traveling any farther up the hair shaft and breaking the hair. I left this on for 5 minutes, then rinsed thoroughly and applied a small amount of Redken Extreme Conditioner just to continue to even out the porosity before I apply my Shades EQ glaze.
Did her CAT treatment, I came back over here and blow dried her hair 100% dry. It's important to do that to see exactly how high you lift it so you can properly formulate for your glaze and your desired tone. So Alice lifted to a really nice level 10 blonde, and our result that we want to go for is a cool, almost white result. So here's my formula. I've picked out 09 Violet, 09 Titanium, and some clear to keep it from going too dark. The reason I chose the 09 Violet is so that I have just violet with no background, just violet tone to cancel out the gold that we have right now and refine it. And then the 09 Titanium has a black to gray background with a silver blue tone. So on top of that violet, after the violet has canceled out the gold, it'll impart even more of a cool tone and give me more of that white kind of cool result. To apply my Shades EQ glaze, I split into four different quadrants. Starting from the top to the bottom, I take quarter inch partings and apply all the way down to zone 3, making sure that zone 3 is fully saturated. Is Shades EQ. I love Shades EQ because it's completely acidic, so a lot of color lines will kind of fib a little bit when they say it's completely acidic, but Shades EQ does not. It lives underneath a 7, which makes it, or on the 7 on the pH scale, which makes it truly acidic, and so I love glazing, toning, shining up with Shades EQ because not only does it shine it up because of the acidity, but it closes down the cuticle, leaving them with better color for a longer lasting time. So I just really love Shades EQ, and I use it for pretty much any time I can. I use it. Refreshing color, toning, glazing, literally everything. And if you think about it, when we're lifting hair with lightener, I mean, lightener lives on the pH scale around, you know, anywhere from 12 to 13, sometimes a little higher for different brands. And that's really far above where hair naturally lives at a 4.5 to 5.5. So when we're lifting that high up and exposing that cuticle to damage, we really need to be taking care of it. And there's no easier way to take care of it than when we're glazing it to get our desired result color. And Shades EQ helps me do that and bring it back to its acidic state that it should be in.
After letting her glaze sit for 20 minutes, it's time to rinse it out. This time I chose to shampoo with Redken Nature and Science All Soft Shampoo. After thoroughly rinsing, I apply Pureology Strength Cure Superfood Treatment for 5 minutes. During our consult, Alice decided she just wanted to trim her hair a bit and add a few more layers. So after dividing into 4 separate quadrants, I just take about an inch off the length. For her layers, I start in the front 2 quadrants and determine how short she wants her layers to be. After determining that, I use the technique of swelling to give her a nice flowy layer. When connecting to the back, I bring everything in the crown, back, and nape sections to scooping with volume to the bottom. And I overdirect everything to the center section. Now that our cut is complete, it's time to style. And every good style out starts with the right products for the job. For Alice's hair, I first chose to use Pillowproof Blow Dry Spray. This product is not only a great primer for other products, but helps kind of preserve the style for hopefully a few days for Alice. Then I chose to layer Redken One United, which has 25 benefits. This product helps me get a smooth, frizz-free blow dry, as well as help with detangling. When I started diving deep into Redken products, I realized that they do exactly what they're designed to do. And as a stylist, I don't want to send anything home with my clients that doesn't perform up to my standards. Thanks to the dedication and major effort that Redken puts into their products, I don't have to worry about that. Before I start styling Alice's hair with my flat iron and giving her some loose wavy curls, I layer Iron Shape 11 to give heat protection and style preservation.
So here's our finished canvas on Alice after lifting with Flash Lift Bonder inside and then glazing with Shades EQ Gloss.